as governor and commissioners, I'm wondering what your main concerns are of the state.
Well, I will tell you, I have about 4 or 5 major concerns. Number one, the federal government recently reduced the LIHEAP monies that come from the federal government to the state, from roughly $60 million down to $23 million. That's a very dire concern of mine, because I am very, very concerned with the cost of heating oil, and the fact that our homes are 80% heated by oil is going to cause some difficulty this winter. So we're looking at every place and everything we can do to find an answer to that problem. Number two, I think our energy costs overall are way, way out of control in the state of Maine. And over the next 4 years, I would like to reduce the number of homes on heating oil by 40%. I would like to get them into natural gas, wood pellets, and electricity. And electricity, if we, with the new technologies that are coming out, we may be able and buy cheaper electricity from our northern friends, we may be able to heat homes at about a third of the price of oil. So that's another big issue. Thirdly, I said earlier, reducing income tax on our retired folks. That, to me, is very, very critical. It's very critical for a number of reasons. Number one, it will hopefully prevent some people from leaving for 6 months of the day, and they might only go in January, February when it's really cold, and come back in March when it starts to warm up, number one. So they'll be here 10 months a year instead of 6 months a year. They'll spend more in our economy, it will help the economy. Number two, if the grandparents are here, there's a much better chance of keeping their kids and their grandkids here. And number three, and the most important, is our elderly. Our retirees have a lot of wisdom and a lot of life knowledge. And if they go away, we lose tremendous abilities to move our state forward. So those are some of the reasons why I believe we need to keep our elderly in mind. And finally, a very big concern of mine is the state of Maine has, like the United States of America as a whole, has become an entitlement state along as well as an entitlement country. In order for us to compete globally, we must do a better job with our kids in school. We must do a better job training our kids how to work. And we gotta do a better job training our children to become self-sufficient.
Hear, hear.
And so that our economy can grow.
I'd like to get more of our commissioners involved in this discussion, so follow up on that.
Come on.
I know. They are here, you know. So we can't ignore them, Governor. Commissioner Bowen, let's start out with you. There's a lot that's being talked about right now with education reform. We've got a session coming up that's going to be very important. What are some of the initiatives that you're working on? I know you can talk. You love talking.
I'll keep it brief. I've got a little folder to give the governor before he leaves today. Sort of laying out the discussions he and I have had about laying out what we want to try and do around education reform. And what we've been doing is spending a lot of time looking at sort of high-performing school systems around the world. I just got back from a conference out in Seattle, actually, with innovative school districts from all around the world, South Korea, Finland, parts of China, some Canadian provinces, that are really doing some cutting-edge work around education transformation. And this is not about sort of nibbling around the edges and doing the kinds of stuff that we've typically done in education over the last few years, which is we change our standardized tests, or we adopt a math program, or we do this or do that. It's really looking at the entire architecture of how our schools are run. Because as all of you know, we all came up through the same system. We all had age-based grade levels. We moved forward by grades. We had ABC report cards, we have, that system's been in place for more than 100 years. It's in an old industrial era, factory era model of schooling. We group kids together by age when they're 5 years old. They put them on the assembly line, they go chunk to chunk down the assembly line in a pack, and it works for some kids. Some of our kids do exceptionally well in our schools. They go on, they have great careers, they get higher education degrees, and they do great things, but not nearly enough. And far too many of them don't make it out of high school. Far too many who do don't go on to such post-secondary education, they're not ready. Many do go on, struggle when they get here. So what we're gonna do is look at what these high-performing systems have done around system transformation, taking some new approaches on education. And what you'll see here in a few weeks, if I can get time with the government to send out and work out our plan, is really a pretty broad agenda of things we want to do around things like teacher effectiveness. We want to look at expanding options for kids, learning options for kids. We want to figure out ways to provide more access to career technical education and other opportunities like that. Digital learning is exploding all over the world. Our kids have access to all kinds of learning opportunities they never had access to before. We need to be sure those opportunities are there. We want to look at the kinds of things the government's been talking about college transition and post-secondary transition, making sure kids get some type of post-secondary education and training. Maybe it's in a career, maybe it's a college degree, and streamlining a lot of those programs and working with our partners in higher education to make those things happen. So you'll see here in a few weeks, I think we'll be able to roll out a pretty ambitious set of pieces we want to do in education.